student. Sorry if there's an echo in here. It sounds like there's a bit of an echo in here. Today we are going to be doing a Q&A all about university. Thank you so much to everyone who put in their questions on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. And if you want to be involved in the next Q&A, make sure that you keep an eye on our social medias. They're always linked in the description box below and you can ask your question in the next one. So, the first question comes from Lucy. Thank you so much, Lucy, for sending in your question. I'm reading it from my phone, so I'm going to read it out. It's kind of a two-parter, but it's all about friends at university. Where did you meet the people where you became the closest friends with? Was it lectures, accommodation, freshers, group chats before uni, etc.? Lucy is in a group chat with people going to the same university as her. They're not in her accommodation, so should she be worried about that? First of all, I met my best friend, who is still my best friend to this day, about 5 years later, in a lecture during my first year. So that is definitely one place where I found I met a lot of friends. What I would say is I also met a lot of my friends at house parties. So I was in accommodation with 7 or 8 other girls during my first year. And I know you touched in this question, Lucy, on things like accommodation and group chats. So we got together a group chat before we got into university, as in physically. So we went on the Facebook and obviously found each other through that. And that was super helpful to kind of all get to know each other and get to know a bit about ourselves and what courses we were doing. No one was actually taking either of my two subjects that I started off with at university, which, side note, was psychology and film media, both of which I ended up dropping, which is a complete other story. It was super useful to make friends that way and to have that university group chat. Another way that we made friends is when I was moving into university, the top tip I can give is to leave your door open. Because if you move into university and you're moving into halls and your door is just closed, people aren't going to feel like they can approach you necessarily because it's taking that extra step of like, should I knock on their door? Is that awkward? I don't know. So leaving your door open with a doorstop is super, super helpful to make friends. I really don't want anybody to be nervous about making friends at university. You guys are all genuinely great. If you're asking these kind of questions, that you're wanting friends, you're going to make friends, okay? You don't need to be the biggest extrovert. I was pretty introverted compared to what I am now during my first year. And I remember I met such great friends. I met so many friends at clubs and societies. This is such a good way of connecting with people who have similar interests with you. So I was a part of musical theater society. I'm making sure that I was going to the clubs and societies fair and just signing up to as much as I was interested in, because you can always kind of weed it out at the end, like, oh, you know, I went to the Give It A Go for this society. I didn't love it, but hey, I met loads of friends. So that's definitely a way. Clubs and societies, sports societies as well, they tend to be heavy on the social side of things. So they'll go out drinking a lot, they'll go out partying, but everyone at Stirling University was really good. Like, I don't drink alcohol a lot, which is a personal choice. It was something I was quite worried about, actually going into university and feeling like I might be the outcast. But even as part of sports societies and everything, and the Give It A Goes for those, people were super chill about that, and it was a really good way to make friends with similar interests. I would say another way to make friends is definitely on your course. Now, if you're in a lecture, it can be slightly daunting when you first go to university and you're looking at this big lecture hall. You might be on your own. Some of your flatmates may not be in your same classes with you. Let me tell you, I was so nervous. I was basically shaking. I mean, I remember walking into my first ever lecture and it was a psychology lecture and I knew absolutely no one. I just kind of like tiptoed my way in. I was running like really early, so there was only a few people there. And I kind of thought that the lecture hall was pretty big. I thought I'll sit kind of middle front where people seem to be gathering a little bit. Well, a group of 3 girls actually, who I'm still friends with, came and sat kind of near me. And I was sitting going, oh, I don't know, like, I really want to make friends, but I'm nervous. And then one of them reached over, leaned over, and she was like, oh, hi. And I was like, oh, hi. And from there, we were friends. And that kind of gave me the confidence to know that I can walk into a lecture and be like, hey, is anyone sitting there? And usually people will just be like, no, come join, and it's really fun, and you make a lot of friends that way. Freshers Week is a really big way to make friends. Freshers Week is completely packed with so many activities, a little bit for everyone, and kind of getting that initial bonding. A lot of the time that can be the first time people have gone out drinking, the first time people have just been out in large groups. What I would recommend is getting together with the flatmates you've met, and hopefully you find one or two people at least that you like, that you're friendly with, and you go to these freshers events and just start talking to people. Not all of them are kind of like nightclub events usually, so just make sure that you're going to a lot of them. That is a great way to meet people. One kind of disclaimer I want to put is something that's slightly difficult to talk about, but something that I do want to share with you guys, because it's something that I wish someone had explained to me when I was first starting university, which is you meet a lot of people during your first week, during your first few weeks, during your first few months, and you think these are all going to be my absolute best friends, ride or die, the whole of university. And sometimes I have friends where that was the case, which is amazing, and you know, 5 years later, we're still friends. However, sometimes you meet, because you just meet so many people, you do kind of, you can drift away from certain groups and certain people, and you shouldn't feel bad about that. If your friendship was like really, really close the first week of university, and then you guys kind of drifted away to people that were more in your subject areas and you found interest with other people, I'm not saying stop being friends with the people that you meet. I'm just saying that if you do happen to change friendship groups, please don't feel that pressure. I think a lot of people get told, like, the friends at university are the friends you'll have for life. And a lot of the times that is true, but I don't want you to feel like you have to hold on to absolutely every single person that you meet during Freshers Week, even if you don't feel like they are like, they might not be a good fit for you in the long run. You guys might have gelled really well in Freshers, but found that you have nothing to talk about, no common interests. So make sure you're not beating yourself up about that. People do tend to drift into groups around second year in university. Just make sure you're happy, you're surrounding yourself with a great group of people that are going to support you, that you have common interests with. I want to say it's not just you don't need to make all your friends in the first week of university. I felt that way. I thought it was like school. Okay, I'm gonna be with these people for the next 4 years. If I don't make friends, best friends in the first week, I'll be an outcast and everything. It is not the case. I was still making friends up into, you know, the end of fourth year and beyond. You know, there's never a cutoff point where you think, okay, I've been here for a week, I'm crying, I hate it, I have no friends, I will never make a friend. That is simply not the case. You will make so many friends. Okay, I just want to let you guys know that you can make friends in the comments, you can make friends on the Facebook, post on the Facebook group, post on, you know, follow the Twitter and find people who follow the Twitter of the Lazy Student and connect with these people. That's a huge point of what I want this channel to be about, is people finding a place to connect with common interests and, you know, people that are all a bit nervous about university and all just don't know what's going on. I'm trying to provide you guys advice and tips, but you are the people driving that. You are the people that are making the friendships and bonding, and that would be absolutely magical if you could all help each other out and just be better friends through the Lazy Student. And that's something I really hope. But I do just want to say all of you are going to make so many friends. You're just, I can't stress enough that you're going to have a wonderful time and make so many friends. You can make friends in lectures, you can make friends in your accommodation. I made friends with all the porters and the cleaners and the, like, everyone, okay? You're going to make so many friends, and it doesn't need to be a huge group. If you don't want it to be, it can be like 1, 2, 3 small amount of people, or it can be the whole university. Another way that I did find moving through university making great friends was during my second year, I was on the freshers team, and then during my third year, I was captain of the freshers team with 3 other people, and that was an amazing way to make friends, because the first year being a part of a team of like 40 people, that was 40 new friends, amazing. We had such a good intensive 2 weeks. And then being captain, moving into an even more kind of overseeing team leadery job, that was still a really good way to find friends. So I definitely recommend doing the freshers team. Not only are you friends with everyone in the team, but you meet new freshers and create even more friends, and it was honestly a wonderful experience. So I just want to let you know there are so many ways I've not even mentioned: going out into town, going to the nightclubs and the open mics and everything like that. You are going to find someone anywhere that your interests lie, and that's so important to know that it isn't as scary as you think. All of you watching this right now probably have some kind of doubts. Now think of how many people have watched this. Think of if it's 10, 50, 100 people that felt the same way you do, and you all just want to make friends. So please, if you are watching this, go and make friends when you get to university. Go and say hello to everyone that you meet. Go and sit next to people in lectures. Go and get to know your classmates. Go and say hello when you first move into your halls, okay? Be nice to each other. What we'll do, because that was a really long Q&A answer, is we will split this into each question gets its own little video, I think. Just because I didn't expect it to be so long, but please tune in hopefully next week. I'll keep you updated on social media. Obviously during this lockdown, what you gonna do? Just trying to film some videos, you know? But if you have any more questions, please do send them in. And thank you so much again to Lucy for sending in that question. Good luck, you guys, for making friends at university. You don't even need the good luck, because you're all absolutely wonderful, amazing unicorns, and you're going to make so many friends. So I will see you in the next video, and yeah, stay safe, stay inside, and see you next time. Bye!